But before we get into a chime time, I want you to notice how far apart me and Miss Atwood are. This is called social distancing.
Yes.
Why do we have to social distance, Miss Atwood?
We don't want to catch each other's germs.
So, because it's just the two of us in our room, and because we are so far apart, you'll notice that we're not wearing our masks. That's because I want you to be able to see me and hear me, but as soon as we have more people in this room, or maybe we're a little bit closer together, we'll have to make sure to put our masks on.
Our masks.
Okay? So, just make sure when you come to school each day, you have your mask ready to go. Okay? So for chime time, the reason we do this is to start our day in that green zone. We want to be calm, we want to be ready to learn. That means that you need to be in your learning space. So if you're not in your learning space right now, I want you to pause the video, and I want you to walk over there, and I want you to sit your bottom down just like I am, just like Miss Atwood is, okay? Looking like you're ready to learn. When we do our chime time, I'm gonna ring the chime. You're gonna close your eyes. You're gonna breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Slowly and quietly, let's try it in through your nose and out through your mouth. Listening to the sound of the chime. Miss Atwood, can you go turn the radio off? Because
yes.
I'm sure that that's gonna distract us from our chime time. Miss Atwood and I were having kind of like a little dance party before you came. Okay? So, I'm going to read the back of this so that you know all about chime time and you can listen for the sound of the chime. It says, to start our core practice, we sit comfortably and close our eyes or look down at our hands. When you hear the instrument, listen as long and as carefully as you can. When the sound has faded completely, begin to focus on each breath. When you hear the sound again, listen as long and as carefully as you can. Keep breathing calmly. When you can't hear the sound any longer, slowly open your eyes and remain still and quiet. So that makes me think we're going to hear the chime two times. The first chime is to tell us that it's a chime time. We close our eyes and we start our breathing. The second chime is the one we want to listen to extra carefully. We want to listen to it as long as we can, and we can't hear that sound anymore, that's when we slowly open our eyes but remain quiet. Are you ready for our first chime time, Miss Atwood?
Let's try it.
Okay, let's try it. Feel like you're in the green zone, ready for us to put some things on the smart board here so that we can go through our first morning meeting. So the reason that we do this is so that we can come together as a team and talk about the way that we're feeling, what we hope to accomplish that day, and one of the things that helps us do that is a schedule. So up here, you can see what a normal school day would look like. But we're not in school.
No.
And it's not a normal school day yet.
Right.
Right? So as first graders, we want to do all of these things. As teachers, we would love to do all of these things, but we're just not there
not yet.
Okay? And there's that power of yet. We're gonna get there. Okay? Eventually we'll have all of these things, but our bodies and our brains aren't ready for all of these things yet. That would be a lot. So the only things in our whole schedule here that we're gonna be doing today are morning meeting. If I could get it to move over, that would be great. And something called Sanford Harmony. We're going to talk a little bit more about that later. Okay, so you can see that we don't have reading yet. We don't have Letterland. We don't have math. You're still going to have lunch at your house, and you can play outside to give yourself a break. That would count as recess. Okay, but the only things you're going to see on Seesaw right now are morning meeting and Sanford Harmony. Next week, we're hoping to jump into maybe some reading and some Letterland, and then eventually we're gonna do math, okay? There's not gonna be any live Zooms until Miss O tells us that that's something we're allowed to do. So right now, you're just gonna see videos like you're seeing right now on Seesaw, and then I'll send a message to your families when we're allowed to get on the computer as a big group.
Good.
Sound good, Miss Atwood?
Sounds good.
All right, so we can actually check morning meeting off the list because that's what we're doing right now, right? Check.
Yeah.
So I might draw lots of my cool shoes. But usually when we put on certain clothes, they make us feel good. So we want us to feel good in this classroom. So your job on Seesaw today is to draw something that you like to wear. It could be a favorite shirt, could be shoes. What about you, Miss Atwood?
Favorite pants, even watch, like to fix your hair, those kind of things.
Jewelry, maybe you have like a certain necklace that you, or a hair barrette, some kind of bow that you like. You could probably draw one more than one thing.
Yeah.
You could put a whole outfit.
A whole outfit be fine.
Ooh, you know what I was thinking for boys that I like to wear sometimes? It's like a sports jersey.
Oh,
if there's
like
a team that I like, that might make me feel special to be part of that team. Okay? So it says, we love you, Mrs. Peterson.
And Mrs. Atwood.
Okay? So boys and girls, thank you so much for joining us on our first morning meeting. Make sure you go to the activities tab because you're going to see this assignment to draw something that makes you feel special. Bye!
Hope your day is good.